Sunday, the 21st of July, 2019. So there's also said to be maybe three particularly sleazy IC1 males at that hostel at the moment, who seem to be sitting around waiting to try and coerce me into conversations with them every time I come and go. They seem to think because I spend Friday night and Saturday night in, that obviously I haven't got a boyfriend and I'm full of fucking shit. Okay, now I have got a boyfriend. I'm very happy with my boyfriend. I don't want to trade it in for another one. I like this one very much. He's very good looking. He's certainly good enough for me. Am I good enough for him? I mean, he's seen my fucking criminal profile thing from the police. It's all being blacktailed, so maybe I'm too dangerous to mix with him, you stupid fuckers. So my boyfriend, yeah. I don't go down to the pub with my boyfriend on Friday or Saturday nights. I don't drink. I don't like sitting in pubs. Yes, I'm aware they sell lemonade for a rip-off price in a pub for £1.50. I'd rather my boyfriend go to the pub with his brothers and his mates than have a miserable female around who doesn't like fucking pubs anyway. I don't like pubs. I go out, I see my mates in the daytime. Sometimes I go up to his. I spend the afternoon in with him, the evening in with him, sometimes the night in with him. I mean, he's my boyfriend, you know. And what I don't want is some particularly sleazy ones who are at that hostel at the moment. There's three I could walk around and put fucking tags on them the second they get up. I can't be asked. I don't want anything to do with them. They're sleazy. I have a boyfriend. I'm very happy with him. And just because you don't see me around walking around and holding hands with my boyfriend all day, do you know what? I'm an adult woman. I'm 55 years young. I can get through a whole day without having to clutch onto a member of mankind, holding his hand. Oh, please hold my hand. I can't go on. I've had too much witness intimidation. My boyfriend knows exactly where I am. He's got more friends near me than you cunts would have for hot dinners for your whole life. Just remember that. My boyfriend's very much liked. His family very much liked. I'm part of his family now, so leave us alone. And don't try and think, oh, because Storm's in on Friday and Saturday nights, oh, she must be up there so lonely in that top floor of the hostel. No, I'm up there getting peace and quiet headspace. If I want company, I go out in the daytime. I find my friends who are out in the daytime. Or I go around and visit them at their flats. So it doesn't mean you can be cracking on to me because you think I'm upstairs bored and lonely. I'm also in the middle of a very big court case, which means if you do want to try and coerce me to have a conversation with you, you'll find my whole conversation for the whole conversation is going to be no comment, no comment, no comment, no comment, no comment. Legally, I can say no comment until I'm blue in the face. Any more harassment in this town, and that's all I'm going to say to people now, is no comment, no comment, no comment, no comment, no comment. You're desperate to get some hot gossip. Well, you know, I've had nothing but shit in this fucking place since I've been here in Bath. So, you know what? Unless you're really a fucking friend of mine whose phone number, I do have my boyfriend's phone number, you know. I'm not that fucking lost. It won't take me long to find him. But unless you want me saying no comment, no comment, no comment, no comment until I'm blue in the face, and I'll get bored before I do that, believe you me, and I'll walk off. Don't waste your fucking time. I'm not interested. And I care about my boyfriend very, very much. And I don't want you sniffing around his bird, who is me. And on the same token, leave him alone, you know. He don't want your bitches or your dicks sniffing around him. And I'm saying that precisely to 5-0s, because he don't like police. He doesn't like the ones in uniforms. He don't like the ones who are not in uniforms. You know, we are a breed, our breed. He's also my family, so you leave him alone. Leave his friends alone, leave his brothers alone, leave his sisters alone, leave his cousins alone, leave his nephews alone, leave all of us alone, grandchildren, all of us. And I'll say bye for now, friends, because I've got to convert these two now. Okay, bye for now.